Vocal Zoid is a vocalist, stage performer, dancer, songwriter, and vocal coach. Original name is Zolani Ngani from Nyanga East in Mau Mau. He started singing at the same age as Uden and he's still doing it today. Vocal Zoid has worked with the likes of Casper Nyarvis, Nasty C, OK Maulum, Cool Cat, as well as Idram Beats. He's here to share us his talent. He also does everyday programming, teaching music in a choir in his township to help better his community. And then we've got the SAE Institute, a creative school based in Woodstock. They have opened another campus in Rosebank, Johannesburg, and partnered with the likes of AKA, Ready D, Oskido, Black Coffee, Jeremy Loops, DJ ZINHLE, and many, many more. Director Trenton Birch is here in studio to tell us about the SAE. DJ Ready D is also in studio. Now, you know DJ Ready D without a doubt. He's South Africa's number one DJ. He has won the SADMC champion 4 times and also won the Western Cape Regional Champs and DJ of the Decade Awards. DJ Ready D is a patron for SAE. We've got Mo G, better known as Muhammad George. He's a South African singer, dancer, born and raised in Cape Town by a family of musicians, has performed in musical venues ranging from the Fostering Foundation. He has learned from legendary Sophia Foster and has ever joined the foundation and performed in big platforms like Sekunjalo Edu Jazz Festival in 2017, Cape Town Jazz Fun in 2018. Moji is here to tell us about his musical career. On the ones and twos this evening, you know what they do? You give people what they want, backed by popular demand. It's DJ Boogie. Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Lama Moon. I'll be your host this afternoon. It's time for us to go live. This is Ekse. Thank you. And yes, that is DJ Boogie on the ones and twos is going to be here till the hour of five, ladies and gentlemen. He was here giving us the things that we love. Apago Ekse last week, so we heard your cries, your pleas, saying that he did best, so we must bring him back. It is the biggest, the baddest, and the most hip and happening show in town. We go by the name of Ekse Live. My name is Lama Lee Moon. You can follow us on Facebook, it's Ekse on K-Town TV. On Twitter, it's Ekse underscore live. We can call that lovely number 021-448-0448. Legends are in the studio this afternoon. One is DJ Ready D. Needs no introduction, really. And then I'd love to say happy belated birthday, because I learned that it was your birthday on Monday, Trent. What did you
looking
do
up,
to...
What
did you do to celebrate?
It was a Monday, so I didn't do anything.
Oh, okay.
Well, I postponed it for 2 weeks. So.
Ah, there goes nothing.
But I am going to celebrate it.
Oh, wonderful. But today we're here to talk about the SAE Institute and what it does for the people. It has been in existence since 1976, and I understand that over 24 countries benefit from this institute. So for people who do not know what SAE, because it's a fabulous institute, what can you tell them about it?
So we are a global institute. We have a branch in Cape Town, Woodstock, and we've just opened one in Johannesburg. Mm. And we teach animation, audio and film. So we're a creative media institute that teaches those three disciplines. 3 year degrees and 1 year higher certificates across those three disciplines.
Wonderful. So if one chooses a scholarship in music, what are they to learn there?
I mean, you do a 1 year higher certificate, so the scholarship program we have cover 1 year higher certificates.
Yes.
So if you're doing sound, you'll learn everything from recording to producing to mixing, mastering, everything across the spectrum. A lot of people think studying sound and music is just about making beats. But there's a much, much wider market in terms of job opportunities and different disciplines within the sound space. So we teach all of those disciplines to make sure people have the best opportunity possible for success.
Ken, and then there's the SAE Patron Scholarship. What is that all about?
So this here is one of our patrons.
Yes.
We have scholarships with AKA Black Coffee, Young Guru, who's Jay-Z's engineer from New York, Hlubi and Mboya. We just launched on with DJ ZINHLE, Jeremy Loops, Oskido, and Temba, aka Euphonic. Mm. So we have 9 scholarships every year that SAE carries the funding for, and they're all in partnership with somebody who's prolific in the industry and who's back to the industry. So, you know, Ready D was the perfect partner for us on this, and we've been running it for about 4 years now.
That's right.
Yeah. Trenton, the patrons. The list of the patrons read like legends. How do you handpick the people that you work with? Like, you're working with Ready D now. So what does it take for an artist to be attractive enough for you to say, hey man, let's work together?
I mean, I think it's all about the energy of the artist. You know, we don't just look for the biggest artist or the most famous artist. We look for people who encompass the spirit of scholarship and giving back. So all the scholarships are in partnerships with a nonprofit called Bridges for Music. Mm. We're building a music and entrepreneurial school in Langa Township. Mm. So they're all in partnership with the nonprofit. So it's all about giving back to the community, giving back to the country, giving back to young people. So the artists we tend to work with are people who have that history, have that legacy, have that sensibility. Mm. So obviously, Ready D's been working with young people for a long, long time, so it made perfect sense.
So there's a campus in Woodstock, there's a campus in Johannesburg, Rosebank. You said something about Langa. What's happening in Langa?
So that is a Bridges for Music school. Yeah. So Bridges for Music is a non-profit. And there is a music and entrepreneurial school opening there in July. Mm. So there's a very close relationship between SAE and Bridges for Music. So all these scholarships are partnerships, and we do events together, and there's a lot of cross-collaboration between the two.
Okay, wonderful. Ready D, your phone rings, and I'm sure that it happens a lot, and people will be like, come man, we've got this, and I assume that you do not say yes to all of them. What made you say yes to this particular project?
Yeah, for me, saying yes to this particular project was kind of understanding what SAE was all about and what they were trying to accomplish as well. Yeah. And also having a platform to make something available, you know, to people that come from disadvantaged communities, people that are really passionate, people that are serious about being a part of the industry as well. So this platform really allowed me to be able to be a part of this journey and also to create these opportunities. And to see people excel, for me, it's really exciting as well. And like Trenton had mentioned, it's not just about producing the beats and the music. Developing as a human being is very important, because that's also going to be the deciding factor in terms of how long you're actually going to be around in the industry as well.
Yes.
So when you come into the institution and see what's taking place, you know, you get to interact with people, you get networking opportunities, there's other opportunities that actually come out of that. So apart from the scholarship on our side, we also got our DJ Academy that's housed there for two semesters a year at SAE. We just rebranded into the Beat Bangers DJ Academy. It used to be known as the Scratch Lab.
Yes.
So, I mean, that's another added component. So in terms of building relationships and building all these opportunities, we now have the scholarship in place, and now we have an official DJ school that's running there as well.
Mm-hmm.
And it's been there for about 3 years, moving on to about 4 years right now as well.
Yeah, 3 years in the running, you working together. What are some of the success stories that you'd love to brag about?
Sure. I mean, from our side, coming out of our DJ school, we now have two South African DJ champions that have come out of there.
Mm-hmm.
The one guy just landed his own radio show. This guy's traveled the world. DJ Gremlin from Cape Town City.
Mm-hmm.
We have a lady that kind of hit, she hit the block. She was a professional traveling DJ. She decided that she wanted to come and study with us. And she's back on the circuit, DJing across the globe. She's now selling her brand at the moment on a global platform. So that's some of the really key stories. Some people have come to study with us, and they all got different reasons and motivations. And to get the feedback and just to know that the people that have come to study with us, there's actual real world and it's tangible, and they can actually see the progress. And some of them are actually coming back as motivational speakers and as instructors coming back to us as well. So for me, that's really exciting to see people grow on that level.
Wonderful. Trenton, before I let you guys go, I've got two questions. What is the message that SAE wants to tell?
I think there's a wider message, you know, from my perspective, and obviously British Music and SAE's perspective, is that a lot of people don't really understand what the entertainment industry is about. And they see what they see on TV, and they see what they see on, you know, hear what they see on the radio, and that's very much the front end. There is a very big industry behind all of the stuff you see at the front, and there are a lot of career opportunities. But I think the main takeout for me is there's a saying we have, it's 50% skill and 50% will. If you are not prepared to work extremely hard and be extremely committed and dedicated, and you want a 9-to-5 job, it's not the industry for you. You know, a lot of people think it's easy to be a DJ. I mean, if you look at what Ready D's done, it's taken his whole life.
Yeah.
You know, and he lives and breathes it. He's deeply passionate and committed and driven. And that's what it needs to make it. And a lot of people don't realize
it. And there are very, a lot of talented people. However, they do not have the stepping stone, which is what you are offering. So the young people that are watching right now and want to be part of this institute, want to receive this scholarship, where can they get hold of you and what criteria?
So the scholarships open at the end of the month, end of next month, on our website. Just Google SAE South Africa.
Yeah.
The whole process is laid out on that. Now, you have to have a matric because it's a Council of Higher Education regulation.
Yes.
But we're not just looking for the smartest people or the cleverest people. We're looking for the people with the most passion and the most drive.
Yeah.
And their story, what that compels us. You know, we pick three essays and we give them to Ready D. He reads them and he chooses depending on the story. It doesn't have to be in the perfect English, but it's about the story and the passion, and we unpack that. Because ultimately, we want people that are going to take this opportunity and make the most out of it.
Okay. Speaking of taking an opportunity, there are people that did not have an opportunity growing up to go and study because of funds. Do you have an age group? Perhaps he's 35 and he still wants to learn?
You're never too old to learn. You know, we're moving into a world where lifelong learning is key to anybody to succeed when mechanization and robots take over. So it's important to learn. So there's no age limit. We have people at the school from, you know, 18 straight out of high school to their 40s. You know, never too old to learn.
Okay. Ready, what makes you excited about SAE?
So for me, walking into a space like SAE gets me excited. The minute I get out of that lift, it's like you're walking into this creative space right through You know, the when you look at the location itself and what's on offer, and for me, I get very excited by equipment.
Mm.
So you're going through the one end and you're walking past all these computers, and then you're looking at all these keyboards and you know what the outcomes are. And then you walk to the other side of the building and you're walking into this practically world-class recording studio. So for an artist and a DJ, you can imagine how that makes your mind spin.
Mm.
And when it's time for us to actually do our DJ courses, we roll out all the equipment, and once the room is packed with people, you kind of you're in your zone, because you know where this is going to go. You know, everybody's excited, everybody's passionate.
Yeah.
And the minute people start putting their hands on the deck, even entry level, and I'm always fascinated by people that come in and they get onto the decks for the very, very first time.
Yes.
Sometimes I get blown away and I'm like, what did you just do?
Mm.
Wait, reverse, do that move again. And I'm listening to so many other things, you know, because sometimes as DJs, we get caught up, and it's very seldom that you step out of your realm.
Yeah.
And you get a different perspective. And we always teach people need to understand the science and unlocking the secrets of the basics.
Mm.
So when somebody step up to the decks and they're performing basic maneuvers, my head is ready and my ears listening to so many other things, and they don't know that I've just learned something from them.
Yeah.
Then I go home and I try to imitate what they did and I mix it up with where I'm at the moment. So it's a constant learning experience.
Yeah.
So for me, those are the things that really, really excite me.
Speaking of teaching, I don't know if this is a silly question or not. You can say so if it is silly. Never been a DJ, never had aspirations of being a DJ, but now you make this exciting and I want to learn. Do I walk in there with zero knowledge of how to handle the desk and you guys are going to teach me?
Absolutely. If you're passionate about music,
yeah,
that's the first step to being a DJ. You know, all of us, we're all born with soul, we're all born with rhythm, so that is already the natural composition of the natural formula to being a DJ.
Yes.
You come in there, of course we're going to take you through a theoretical process, but we do start from the bare bone basics as well.
Yeah.
And we teach everything from understanding tempos, how to count the beats, song structure. We teach how to mix different genres.
Yeah.
And it's not just about scratching people, no, really, the eye scratches with his arms and his nose and he does funny stuff, but it's not about that. We take you through the whole process. We take you back to the foundations as well. We teach techniques on vinyl. Then we take you to the CDJ platforms and we expose you to new technology as well. So we cut across the board.
Okay. So Trent, it's music, film, as well as animation.
Yeah.
And all of those are still open till month end.
We still have a few weeks left of enrollment, yes.
Okay. So everybody, you go and do that, apply, because we know that you want to be career-driven people, and if you're a creative, this is the platform for you. Thank you very much, Trent and DJ Ready D, for
Thank
the
you.
Work that you do. It's very much appreciated.
Thank
young you. South Africans and young people across the world need people like you.
Thanks
so
a lot.
Thank you very much for coming.
Yeah, thanks for the opportunity.
Now, for a music instructor working in the community, he's also a vocalist. He goes by the name of Zoid. He's ready to take on the Ekse Live stage. Do enjoy.
What's up? What was it? DJ Hero, DJ be the best star. Cape Town, are you ready? Watch, sit, let's just
Thank you.
What you can expect to spend the time doing this weekend. Obsidian 004 finale is an event concept uncovered by Step Various joins the Cape Town clubbing scene with one goal in mind: to create, grow, and guide you into a dimension of techno. Catch this on Saturday at 71 Loop Street from 9 p.m. to 5 in the morning. And then it's hashtag Holy Smoke, which is hosting the first time its first ever hip-hop evolution event called Trap in the City, and will be taking over Cape Town's District 6. Experience a upa ethno night of hip-hop and trap from 9 p.m. till 4 in the morning. Perfect for those who appreciate hip-hop and trap music. Prepare for the best time of your life with amazing sounds just steps away from a bar with full-service amenities. Did we forget to mention that they have a world-class barman? You name the drink, they have it. If you are headed out this weekend, then you have no doubt been watching the Trap in the City social pages religiously. Hip-hop music fans will be able to trap out their heart's content, dress to impress, and bring the squad, because it's gonna be lit. Lastly, Comedy and Magic Experience is a new and fresh platform that showcases funny comedians and mind-blowing magicians live once a month on stage in Ekhayelitsha. Their aim is to teach and introduce people to the exciting art of magic through comedy and create a life-changing experience with their shows. For every last Friday of the month, a CMX show is hosted at a popular venue in Ekhayelitsha. Good music, fashion, food and drinks while you laugh non-stop in amusement is what you should expect. The idea is to help grow the entertainment lifestyle in Ekasi while exposing and celebrating quality performance in the fast-growing entertainment lifestyle in Khayelitsha. Ticket bookings at Director Mawonga Kayani on 074-990-0000. 3306. Now that's the gig guide for this weekend. Welcome to it, everybody. On the ones and twos is DJ Boogie. Yes, it's a boogie o'clock, he says. Ekse underscore live is who we are on Twitter, on Facebook. It's Ekse on Cape Town TV. Remember that hashtag, hashtag Ekse. My vote is to vote for your favorite presenter. It's either Q, Siasanga, or Amy Mayer to be one of the brand new presenters coming through the show. Remember, next week, Friday, the 1st of March, we are announcing the winner for the presenter set. Welcome to Ekse if you just joined us. It's a Friday afternoon, and this is the biggest, the baddest, and the most hip and happening. On to my left is Zoid, the vocalist. Hails from Nyanga, Mau Mau. How are you, my brother?
Yeah, and you're right, Njani.
A little bit feverish, but you're heating up the studio, so
yeah.
I guess I'm going to get better.
Yeah,
so tell me about Uzolani. Where did you grow up? Because I know that you started singing at 10, but life before that, Ngubani Uzolani and the foundation.
Okay, Uzolani is a kid from Nyanga East.
Yeah.
Was raised by two parents, which is Umamam.
Yes.
So I went to church. I was always umakulu kona, umamu kona. So Zolani ekaweni, Zolani ekaweni. So I went ekaweni, and then I was there, and then from then started noticing, okay, I can sing.
Yeah.
You know, from Iri Station back a creche. So ngoku ndiyakhula ndisecaweni kakhulu. So I can sing. Ndathathwa ndadityaniswa nabanye choir master pha ecaweni, and then I sing. Sabe siphuma siya kwi-competition, which is a branch bo Eastern Cape kanje, and then sawina.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then from ekasi I went to Tandokulu High School, Upper.
Yeah,
shout out to my teachers though. They they always excited Cabin Ball and your performer partner again. By Tani Lindinza. Yeah.
So, Bungaban don't know about the guy you're creature and I put a skele game. With those notes.
Whatever. Man. The obvious. Not the bad corner.
Right. Not only do you do Ikom, which you just performed, what other genres do you perform?
Okay, I call myself a vocalist because I know Guti, I'm capable of singing any genre. You know, can't figure studio, they say Nancy, Peter Trap, and then the Kuela Guyo. And I also do a cappella music with a group called the Royalties from Nyanga East, which is the group I started with the other members in Nyanga Arts Center. Yeah.
And now you are a guy who is not selfish about his talent.
Yes.
Because you work in the community.
Yeah.
Every day you've got a music program teaching in a choir.
Yes.
What influenced that decision? Because Abanye Bantu would take their talents and hone them for themselves. But you want to share the knowledge and spread the love of music.
Into the guy, from where I come from, which is Nyanga, Abanye Bantu, they always have la mentality, but Nyanga, you Nyanga.
Yeah.
Come in Nyanga and witness in this nayo, because there is a corner tina and lendo abanye abantu abayivayo asiyazi tina because of sibona writing in here too. And being a vocalist and yenzela mna into yam going in for a studio session was not enough for him. So I thought, okay, you know what, let me just call abantu abakwazi ukula apha, because ngikhela ubabona kwenye ishow yenyanga yethu eZoland Center. But okay, there is a potential up, and then now I can sing, and then people can sing. Why can we sing at Tibani and do something beautiful? And can we, as a skill, I saw some, I'm not here to stay.
Yeah.
I'm here just to write my own book, but Zolano is vocal Zoid. I'm here to leave a mark though, you know.
So not only are you a vocalist, you also can dance, we saw that, and you're a songwriter.
Yeah.
So when did those skills develop, and when did you take note that you've got them?
Okay, dancing, you know, it started after realizing what I can sing.
Yeah.
So we danced for hip-hop music. So that's where I started before, and this was Jivali House, and all.
Yeah.
So I was doing a cramp, J Squad and everything. Is bahambunyaka bachintsha yangena igqom. Bachintsha umuntu, wangena ke igqom. Yabo, so I was inspired by Chris Brown. So I thought, okay, Chris Brown is a stage performer.
Yeah.
Though yena senze hip hop, mna ndenze igqom. then I can sing, I can dance, which is Chris Brown can do those things. So now,
why can't you?
Yeah,
you know, speaking about things that you're asking yourself, why can't you?
Yeah.
Tell me about e projects that you're working on going now forth. Like, do you have an EP, an album coming up next?
Okay, right now, yeah, they are funny when the EP, but I'm still pushing his singles. Featuring other DJs such as Abo, DJ Ndiro, DJ Villelvesta,
hey.
And DJ Rupees. And so many busy kakhulu ngoku. Like ngom so going kwi birthday shandis gap is away too.
Yes.
So basically partying the whole night, giving a shout out to my big guy, Akalana Gopis Wenzum Tolu back then, 2013. And the second March I'll be invading around in Nyanga East. The FBC ka frequency,
yeah.
And then go on a 30 killing up festival ka Bonza to Bendy Park, and then go out of Western Cape to Eastern Cape in King William's Town, whereby I'll be rocking with Awanyama Chita from Durban to East London to PE.
Yeah.
So it's that fame, man. Sekulisana, you know.
Well, ask him one question and he gives you the whole gig guide. You already know what he's going to be doing for the rest of the year. Speaking of working with the DJs, there's DJ Boogie. He works with vocalist. Yeah.
Really?
After this, you approach
yeah.
him and
yeah, we need
you talk about like doing a record
sense of
together.
Music, you know?
Yeah. So you guys think that being a presenter is all glitz and glam and people are perfect on screen? Hell to the no. This is how they mess TV up without you knowing. Check this out.
Oh my gosh, you know what time it is? It's Boogie O'Clock.
That comes that, I'm so sorry. We'll be coming on talking about this project and
live outside broadcast and
And at 9 p.m. on Saturday, we hype it up with Kid Clever and George the Groove.
Oh.
U invite okanye umeme abantu abayi 10. Oh God, this is draining and straining. Take 6.
How many questions can you answer? Find out on.
Must I start from the top?
How many questions can you answer? Find out on 31 questions at 2.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, on Hype It Up. This is your girl Zipo Fakala, aka Mazi, aka. Zish, or call me ZIZIPH Show. This is your girl today on Hype It Up. We're gonna show you the music video. Those top 5 music videos. I'll be right here, right now. Also, we will have, guess what? Just guess. Yeah. MCT. You know? The local artist that is going to be here. But first, before we get to know him better, you know? Let's just go to Ibrahim. Show, show! Oh my gosh, you know what time it is? It's Boogie O'Clock. Oh my gosh, you know what time it is? It's Boogie O'Clock.
Want free smoke, want to tell jokes, want free shows, I just want free. Gonna be, physically can't be clearer.
Peaceful is a struggle for me. Don't pull up at 6 a.m. to cuddle with me. You know how I like it when you loving on me.
On the ones and twos with that fantabulous track. If you have not bought it, yeah, you need to go and buy it. Boogie, where can they buy that song? Where can they buy No Lie? All music platforms, you get that. I love it, personally. I love it. But sitting next to me on the yellow couches now is Moji, who is raised right here in Cape Town by a musical family. He had the privilege of doing a tribute to Michael Jackson back in 2018. He also worked with Lira, the Summer Award-winning songstress on The Voice. So today it's all about talent that we've got in Cape Town. Mohammed, welcome to Ekse. How you do?
I'm good, and yourself?
Well, thank you. tell me about growing up in a musical family. What has that done for your confidence in terms of holding the microphone and being on stage?
Confidence, it helps a lot. Being in a musical family, it's tough.
Yeah.
It's tough, really, because my father comes to me and he says, do you have the right song for the people? You know, the people like old school. And, you know, I'm growing in the 21st century, and it's normally Bruno Mars, now Justin Timberlake, but he wants me to sing the El Jero, me and Mrs. Jones. Like, you know, and they always want me to sing those old school songs for the old people. So it's really tough in a musical family, but they help me a lot. When singing at home, practicing, my father would put a plank against my back.
Wow.
In order to not, when I sing a high note, do that. So the plank will keep my head this and just sing straight, you know.
So would you say that your father is your worst critic and your best instructor at the same time? He's the go-to man.
He is the go-to man.
All right.
He
is. What do you perform the most?
The most? At every show I perform, man, Mrs. Jones, at last. Blame It on the Boogie by the Jackson 5.
Yes.
Spain, El Giro. Oh, but mostly Michael Jackson. I'm a big Michael Jackson fan.
Understandably why. So, Moji, for people who are unfortunately not going to see you perform today on the show, where can they get your performances? Where can they see you perform live?
Well, now on YouTube, they can find my audition on The Voice South Africa. They can find that on YouTube. Just type in Mo George and you will see me there. Also, they will find me on Facebook as Muhammad George, but also on my page, Mo George.
So I hate people, not hate, hate is a very strong word. It confuses me, people doing things just for the sake of doing it. So what does music do for you holistically? Where does it take you as Mo?
Well, I'm doing music because it's in the blood. I love it. It's my passion, and it makes people feel good, which makes me feel good. So if I can entertain people and make them feel good, it makes me happy.
Yeah.
And the reason why I'm also doing music is because I wanna get the exposure. It's really tough in the city of Cape Town, but I know it can happen.
So where can people catch you perform, let's say, tomorrow going forth?
Well, tomorrow I am performing at the Protea Hotel in Stellenbosch. Yes, with the PJ Twins, you know the PJ Twins?
Yes, of course.
Yeah, I'm performing with them tomorrow in Stellenbosch. Next week I'll be back on, next month, yeah. I'll be back on The Voice, getting ready for the next stage.
Wow, congratulations.
Yeah, thank you.
My production manager in Obisutu has not been lucky in love, you know, but now she has recently found a boyfriend, hopefully wedding bells. So should she need a singer up there on the aisle to sing for her coming through, where can people book you, especially her?
Well, if she wants to book me, it's not hard to find, really.
Yeah.
On my Facebook page, my phone number and my email is on there.
Mm.
And she can just call me because I know she has my number right now.
Yeah, what's your Facebook fan page?
My Facebook fan page is just Mo George.
Okay. Mo George is where you find him on Facebook should you need bookings and experience his musical ability. Thank you so much for watching us, bringing you the sauce of entertainment on a Friday afternoon. Right now, it's time for us to head over to Rated R, where we ask your favorite personalities those random, ridiculous, and sometimes crazy questions. This is Rated R. Rated R, the most random, rude, ridiculous, and awesome kind of show that you like. So we're going to be asking those ridiculous questions right now. He must be real quick.
Cool.
Because we're real random.
Okay.
And you must show that you're a real human being, but not a robot.
Okay, sharp. Yeah. Verification vibes.
Yes. What's the last thing that you ate?
Nando's.
What's the last gift that you received and who was it from?
Love, my mother.
Okay. Have you ever cheated on a girlfriend?
No. Yeah, you look guy. That's... Yo, hey, maybe. Yeah, fame. I want to live forever. Perfect.
What's the worst song that you've ever heard on radio and who was it by?
Yo, Scully Pat.
She has a song?
I saw videos on Instagram.
What is this surfing, you guys? What is this surfing?
It was the meat fest, man.
What are you thinking about right now?
Vibes and vibes and vibes.
Okay, what was the last thought last night before you went to bed?
Yo, I can't wait for my sim swap to come through because I need to send messages out to the base about Nsola Sundays.
You last spoke to you on the phone and about what?
My boy Ethan, about studio.
What should people stay away from when it comes to your birthday and they're buying you a gift?
Anything that makes me look fat.
Do you know how to cook?
Yes.
Says who?
Everyone that eats my food.
What was the last meal that you cooked?
The last meal I cooked was pasta. It was a chicken Alfredo.
Who ate it?
A young lady.
All right! what is it that people don't know about you but you wish they did?
That I am not always a joker. I'm actually quite a serious person, yeah.
What are you serious about?
About people fulfilling their purpose.
What do you know for sure?
That Jesus is Lord.
Okay. There's more of Rated R where it came from. So if you've got this favorite artist personality, whoever it is that you want us to chat with, and you've got ridiculous questions that you'd love to ask them, send them through to Ekse on Cape Town TV, and we'll find that artist for you, and we'll be asking those questions. It's Ekse on Cape Town TV on Facebook. On Twitter, follow us, it's Ekse _ live, or call us on 021-448-0448. Like our guests that were here in studio, whether they are performing artists or they're doing great things for their community, you can email us at exe@capetowntv.org or call that number 021-448-0448. Well, if you just joined us, you came to the last segment of the show, but never fear, when Llama is near, I can do the things that make the pots happen. Next week, Monday, between 7 and 8 in the morning, you need to wake up with this greatness so we can hook you up together, my love, together. That's, that was for DJ. Deeply infected, by the way. Boogie, since you were last on Ekse, that was 7 days ago, what did you get up to?
I've been going through a lot, you know.
Your girlfriend broke up with you? What's going through a lot?
No. I mean work-wise.
Yeah?
Work-wise, like, the schedules have been packing. And that's what all DJs want, you know, get the bookings in.
Yes.
And get all those recommendations from people and, you know, secure those bags.
So, on the music charts, how is No Life faring? Because it's a gem. I said this last week when I first heard it, and I'm saying it again. It's a gem.
Yes, it's doing a lot. That's why we shot the music video.
You shot a music video already?
Yeah,
and you didn't think to invite us? What?
I did it before I came here for the first time, so. Mm-hmm. But the video is going to drop on March 26th, which March is on my 26th. Birthday.
Wonderful. Yeah. What are you doing on your birthday?
A lot of events. People have been sending me emails and planning my birthday for me.
So. Are we invited?
Yeah, sure. You guys are going to get invited.
With that music video, No Lie, is it going to be an Ekse exclusive?
Yeah.
He said it. It better be. Yeah, so going forth, are you playing tonight somewhere? What's the gig guide?
Yeah, I'm playing tonight at St. Lounge. Mm-hmm. It's the addiction night, so people should come through and get your party on.
It's a Friday, everybody. Yeah. It's time for us to get our
Friday.
Our weekend on. So that is DJ Boogie. It's time for me to step out of here and let him take over the decks and show you why he is the most sought out DJ right here in Cape Town. DJ Boogie, are you ready? Because it's DJ Boogie
o'clock. Oh my gosh, you know what time it is? It's Boogie o'clock.
Oh, fish on your body. Sure you know no safety when you carry 50 kilos on body. You know I feel a vibe, you feel a vibe, so baby whine about me. Yeah. And I know you shy, but it's cool when we're making love.